One of the most common questions I receive is, Scott, what are the very best power-ups that I should be using with Trello? Well, one of the first questions that I ask in response is, what exactly are you trying to do? And for many of you, you want to have some advanced reporting. For many of you, you want to be able to sync cards between different boards. And for many of you, you want to create subtasks or dependencies. Well, often in the past, I've had to recommend several different power-ups to use. But today I'm sharing with you one of the power-ups that I am recommending on almost a daily basis, and that is Placker, or more specifically, Projects by Placker. In fact, Placker, I think, is perhaps the best all-in-one power-up. So let's dive in and let me show you the features of Placker. So in today's example, I've got three different boards, creatively named Test Board 1, Test Board 2, and Test Board 3. And as you may notice, I have the exact same list across all three of these boards. You can envision these as maybe different teams or different departments or maybe just different people, right? They're all working on their own separate to-do list. But one of the things that we are often asked for or wanting to do within Trello is to be able to see things at a higher level. You know, you manage more than just one board. I'm almost assured of that. How can you see multiple boards at a higher level? Well, by installing the Placker power-up, you can do just that. You can see here in the top right-hand corner, I've got three links to go directly to Placker Board, Placker Gantt, or the Placker Track View. Let me just open up this Placker tab here, and I want to show you what things look like. Now, at first glance, you may say that this looks pretty much identical to Test Board 1. It's the same cards. We have the labels. You can even see my face, which cards I'm assigned to here. But just wait for it, because it gets so much better than this. Yes, you could start managing your projects here within Placker. If I click on any one of these cards and I go over here to this preview pane on the right, I can change dates. I can add a checklist. I can do almost everything that I would regularly do within the Trello interface. But here's where things get really, really neat. In the top left-hand corner, you see something that says Select Boards. Right now, I'm just viewing Test Board 1. But what if I'd like to see how all of these boards are performing in a more concise view? Well, I'm going to select this option, and I'm going to add Test Board 2 and Test Board 3. I'm going to say Load Selected Boards. And now what you will see is that I've got all three boards here on the same page, right? So I don't have to switch between tabs. I've got all three of my boards viewed in front of me. But I think it gets better even yet, because you will notice that there is a combined board setting. Remember, each of these boards have the exact same list, to do, in progress, and complete. I'm going to select Combine Boards. And look at this. Now I've got everything in a concise, in a user-friendly single board. I've got all three of these boards condensed into one. So I can manage and move my cards around. I can change things here across three boards, but just in a single view. I love this, and many of my clients love it as well. That's why more and more of them are starting to use Placker. Now it gets better. On the right-hand side, you can see we can actually see this information in a few different layouts. So if I go over here and I just want to, you know, let's list it by member, I can select this option here and I can quickly see just all of the things that are assigned to me right here. And the left-hand list is just all the things that are unassigned. I can go down to, well, let's list it by label. Let's just filter everything else out by label. Of course, you can search and filter and do something similar within Trello, but not in this manner, right? Not by separate lists, not in the way that things are laid out here within Placker. So this feature alone, this ability to combine boards, let's go back to that default view for just a moment, I think is worth the subscription price to Placker alone. And I have more and more of my clients that are using it just for that reason. But let's keep moving on. Here, let's go to the Gantt view. And I know a lot of you prefer or at least enjoy having a Gantt view of your projects. Now, this is just a sample project, so it may not make sense, all of the different things and the different tasks that I have laid out here. But you can see each one of these icons here or durations represent a task within Trello. But the great thing is whatever you do here, it syncs automatically back to your original Trello board. Now, just for simplicity's sake, I'm actually going to remove two of these boards just so I can go back and make sure that I'm interacting with the right tasks over here. So I'm going to remove those other two boards. We've just got test board one here working. And let's look at task four, right? So here it's about to start. It's about to be finished here at around February 14th. Well, let's say there's a delay or something like that. So task four, let's go back and make sure that it's synced up here. Task four, February 14th, there you see it. There. But let's say I prefer this view and I say I really need to push that out. There's other things going on. I'm just going to drag this out about a week from now. It's going to be due right over here along the 22nd. If I go back, task four, look at that. It's changed it automatically, February 22nd, an instant sync between the Gantt chart and my view here. Let's go one step further and let's say, you know, it's actually going to take longer. It's going to take more than a day. Let's set a duration because that's what a Gantt chart is all about, right? Start time and end time. Now, you're probably saying, well, you haven't changed the end time, Scott, so isn't it going to just look the same within Trello? Well, you're right. It's going to still show February 22nd as the due date here, but if I click on the card, you're going to see something special under the covers, and that is the start date is February 15th, and we still have our due date of the 22nd. It even tells me the duration, 1 week and 1 day. I can edit that either here if I want to, or I can edit that here within the Placker interface. For those who are wanting start dates and end dates, Placker can do that for you as well. Now, just before we go back to the normal Trello view, I want to show you some other enhancements, some other features that Placker adds to the Trello interface. I don't want to miss out on the track view. So track is the third view here within Placker. And here you have so many different ways of viewing and looking at your cards. So for example, here we've got sort of a summary of the end dates here. You know, where are they in this workflow? When are they due? Which ones are overdue? And if I click on this, I'm going to see exactly which of those two cards are overdue. If I click on it again, just like we saw before, I can go in here and edit almost everything that I would normally see in Trello. In fact, more and more often, I find that clients are using Placker as a day-to-day tool. They're going less and less within the Trello interface and more here within Placker because there's just so much power. There's so many different views and graphs. This is just a sample of some of the graphs you can see here. Here you see all of the different widgets, and there's even a card burn down, for example, if you want to see where you should estimate and where you should track. I mean, there's too many to cover in just today's video, but you can have a lot of fun just looking at the different graphs and the different ways that you can view your data here within Placker. But I do want to jump back to Trello to show you some of the other things that get added here within the Trello interface. So here under power-ups, you will notice that Placker actually adds a few additional buttons, including mirroring and adding a dependency. So in this case, mirroring you can think of as syncing with another card. And you know, I want to give this card sort of a unique name here. Let's just go task 423 just so we can see this show up in a different board. So task 423 here, as we see here within the Trello test one board, does not appear in test board two or test board three. So what I want to do is I'm going to open this up. I'm going to select mirror because let's say I do want to sync this with my second board. So I just need to select that board. I can select the list and where I want it to be. And I'm going to say add mirror. It may take just a few seconds, not very long though. And you can see there's even a little link here saying that there is, I can show that card. I can click here and go directly to it. I can edit the mirror as well. I'm not going to click either of those. I just want to go directly over to board number two. Boom. There it is, task 423. I've got a sync between those two. So no matter what I do, either at this side on this board or within my original Trello 1 board, I'm going to get a true sync between the two. You don't need to use another power-up just for syncing capability. You can do that here within Placker as well. The other great thing is that you can also have it sync movements. So if I move this from in progress to complete, another nice thing that you'll see here is that it's going to automatically check it off, because I've told Placker when anything moves to complete, I want you to say that it's checked off. Now, I haven't done anything. I haven't even visited Trello board number 2. I'm going to click on it, and guess what's in my complete list? That's right, task 423. If I move this all the way back to do here in test board number 2, it's going to uncheck it, right? We're not complete anymore. We're still in the to-do phase. Let's go back to test board number 1. Look what's waiting for me, a true sync with this card across multiple boards. The last one, which I'm not going to get into in as great of detail, is the add dependency. So if you need to complete a particular card before something else, you can do so. For example, here you see that this card actually has a dependency. This needs to be finished. Task number 1 needs to be finished before task number 2. That seems to only make sense, right? One before two. But let's go and see what that looks like on a different card. Task number 6, I don't think has a dependency. So let's say I'm going to click on add a dependency. It can either be a predecessor or a successor. And let's say, well, let's add a predecessor in this case. And let's say task number 5. Got to do task number 5 before we accomplish task number 6. So you can see that here. You can see that identified here within the Trello card. It's also identified within the Placker interface as well. So whether you want to create a true sync, whether you want to create dependencies or subtasks, or like I mentioned before, I think just combining boards, right? Selecting multiple boards and seeing them in a single view is one of the best features of Placker. I would encourage you to check it out for yourself. They do have a free trial, so you can test out all of the features which I've shown you here to see if Placker is the right solution for you. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I look forward to your questions about Placker or about any other Trello power-ups. Don't forget to leave me a comment down below and be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe right here to Simpletivity. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.